Kermit's a small town where almost everyone knows each other, so most residents were tight-lipped about their feelings following the arrest of Justin Williams. Some, however, talked to us about the background of the 17-year-old, now accused of a violent sexual assault. According to this probable cause affidavit signed by the Texas Ranger, 17-year-old Justin Williams was arrested just after 1 a.m. early Saturday morning. Williams is accused of abducting a young girl and using a knife to force her into some form of sexual abuse. It's unclear where the alleged abduction began, but we now know that Williams was arrested here at his home on the 700 block of South Avenue B in Kermit.
Does it surprise you that the son of the chief of police would do something like this?
Yes, it's shocking.
Winkler County resident Janice Griffith heard about the incident this morning.
Why is it surprising?
Because I never thought a person like that would do something like that.
But others we spoke with said the opposite. This Kermit teenager, who declined to speak on camera, said he's not surprised that Williams is accused of the crime.
Chief Williams did not return our calls today requesting a comment regarding his son's arrest. It marks the second incident in as many months the Texas Rangers have had to investigate that either directly or, as it does in this case, indirectly involves the Kermit Police Department.
Last month, former Kermit police officer James Slayton was arrested after he allegedly groped a Kermit donut store employee and committed a lewd act in the bathroom.
Well, it's nothing new because it goes on everywhere you go.
Williams' next-door neighbor says she remembers him as a nice boy while he was growing up, but she did describe him as rowdy at school. Tonight, Griffith's thoughts are with the young victim.
I feel sorry for her. I hope she gets better.
Well, the Texas Rangers are still investigating the incident, waiting for DNA and other physical evidence to be processed, in addition to collecting more interviews from witnesses. From reporting in the newsroom, Bo Berman, CBS 7 News.